Do I look frozen? I'm so annoyed with Facebook making me look so bad in these frozen pictures. Anyway, good morning. No, it's afternoon. It's Friday. Woohoo! Friday. This is a lunch break for anybody that has a lunch break. We know many people do not. Some people are asleep. All my children went back to school today for 2 hours. Amos has been home since 10:15. But I'm glad to have him here. He's much perkier. He was acted lethargic at school, but now that he's home, he's had mini wheats and he's watching some Mickey Mouse. He hasn't watched television in a week. You know he's sick when he don't want no TV. Anyway, it's very exciting. And I have to tell y'all, I did an Instagram video this morning. Instagram videos, you can request to be a part of it. It is awesome. So my friend Krista Rizzo of Why Am I Yelling, she hopped on. She was sitting in her car because she lives in Brooklyn. And you have to sit in your car so you can move your car like to the other side of the street. Some cockamamie city thing that I don't understand. Hey, Nicole. So she hopped on there. It's really cool. So that means that if you saw famous people doing Instagram live videos, if you caught them, you could request to be on them. I caught your bronchitis. I know. It sounds, I'm so wheezy and I need to take the prednisone, which I need to be hungry like a hole in the head. But anyway, I had the best time with y'all last night. It's my sausage biscuit. I had the best time with y'all last night. I have never had so many people comment on a blog or a video. It's really exciting. Though one person commented. This is my orange juice. Since I'm sick. You know, I was eating popcorn last night, if you're watching it. And she said, do you always talk with your mouth full? Now, is that actually a real question? I don't think it's a question. I think it's like people that say, did you get your hair cut? Which is passive aggressive for, you got a crappy haircut. So when she said, do you talk with your mouth full? Watching from Wilson. Oh, hell. I'm not coming to Wilson. You couldn't pay me enough to come there. Miss B's watching our preschool teacher. I'll try to behave, Miss B. You talk with your mouth full. And I was like, you can change the channel. I mean, this is not North Korea. You don't have to watch me like Kim Jong-un and like cry and weep when you see me. No, no. You change the channel. You don't like it? You change. Hi from South Carolina. Hi, Barry. So I said that. And she goes, well, I like what you say. I wrote this down. I can't get beyond your rude presentation. I guess that's how I sit like this. Sit up. Stop scratching. What was I scratching? Maybe my nose. And stop shoving food in your mouth. Well, you can't boss me, lady. Because you know what I got? I got a sausage biscuit. And I'm going to eat it. While I talk to you, I'm going to talk the whole time. So, ha! There, you just saw it too. Now, I have some exciting things to report. This is a fascinator for the royal wedding. Did you know there's a royal wedding? Evidently, people are real excited about it. I'm not a real wedding type. But anyway, it's on real early in the morning. There's a time change, you know. I didn't know that. My friend Krista was like, it's on at 6. I was like, what the hell? Do people in England get married at 6 in the morning? Anyway, it's odd. Eat it and talk. Yes, I'm going to. So, now I forgot what I was going to say. Oh, excitement. Jeff Tart, who is a senator, has asked me to come and talk. With him, not to him. So we're going to meet up on Tuesday. I hadn't even told him this, but 4 a.m.? Oh, God, I'm not getting up. I was supposed to get a manicure and a pedicure that day. My mom gave it up to me for my birthday. And now I'm going to have to cancel. So, because I'm going up to the Wolfpack Club Tuesday night to talk to all these anesthesiologists. Having a party at 5 a.m., are you on crack, Kathy? Do people really do that? A party? Maybe I could have a party. Hi from Wales. Well, no, you're in Wales, so that makes sense. I'm so pissed I didn't go to England. I mean, think of all the good post I could have done. Did anyone get their brick discount this morning? I don't know. Did anybody reach out to Watson Sutton? Watson Sutton is probably watching this right now. Are you out there, Watson? Because Watson is, he's bitter. Anyway, I admire how you've decided to be you. Not an easy thing to do. Well, you know what? It's good. Yesterday we went in the new playground and these girls were saying, oh God, Meg's mom's coming to watch the thing. They were like, talking about scales and weight. I was like, you know, I went to the doctor 2 days ago and got weighed because, you know, that has a lot to do with bronchitis. And it said 178 or 176, something terrible. And this friend of mine was like, I can't believe how easily you throw that out there. And I was really thinking about that. Like, I haven't always been like that. But if I throw that out there, then it doesn't own me. You know, like, I know I need to lose some weight and be healthier, not because I'm going to ever be thin. Like, at this point, 156 sounds thin, right? I mean, it's all relative. Anyway, I tried to exercise. I went to the gym one time last week or the week before. And then Amos got sick. And then I remember why I don't exercise. Randy, I'm going to exercise, but we're going to just have to wait until September. So anyway, out drinking beer. Yeah, this Watson Sutton, I mean, I don't know why you hate me. Just because I want teachers to be able to march. That seems so offensive. Watson called me, sort of hurt my feelings, but now today it's sort of made me laugh. Tales of the inebriated debutante. I mean, I was not inebriated. I had one glass of wine.
I don't even drink
a lot. My friends all say I pretend I drink on my blog because it makes people like me. Like Regan and Mary Scott. But I don't.
It is fun, though. Oh, it's a better angle. My biscuit.
You're going to buy a Fascinator this afternoon? I don't know where in the hell you're going to get one. You must not live in Eaton. They don't have them at Rose's. I looked. But that would be a fun shopping trip to do. I also spoke. Go buy a teacher a beer in style. Oh, you made me forget this. Buy a teacher a beer day. I got to put that post up. Does your husband ever say anything to make you feel bad about your weight? No. But he's probably afraid I'd be mean to him. And he did get me a gym membership, but he asked me if I wanted one, and I said yes. And now I've decided that's probably a waste, but it's okay. No, I think he wants me to exercise, but no, he really doesn't. I'm sorry if yours does, because that's sort of shitty. And that will make you, like, eat more. I always say Thomas has the monopoly on exercise. He does so much exercise, it makes me want to be a sloth. So I tell him if he were lazier, I actually might be more mobile. Just a thought. The captain of Highway Patrol called me this morning from Wilson. It's very nice and was very apologetic about his James person that was sharing all the pictures of the teachers, drinking beer. And we had a lovely conversation. And I might feel safe going to Wilson if he agreed to be with me because, anyway, we both agreed. And he said, I appreciate you being a tattletale. He didn't say that, but he did. He said, we don't want our organization represented in a negative way. I'm married to an exercise machine. Ugh. He's probably watching this right now where he's out on like a paddle board. Meanwhile, I've been to McDonald's. I'm home with the children all weekend. We have nothing to do. So we might go to Greenville and like go to the trampoline park. Amos loves the trampoline park. It's like being in hell when you're there with him. Because he runs aimless and just wallows in the foam pit. So then you're trying to dig him out of there. But anyway, he does like it. But he's been sick, so maybe he can't go. Anyway. I don't want everybody sitting around watching TV. I mean, I would like to do that, but I don't want them to do it. What else? That couple that got all pissy over the screenshot stuff. Darn if he did not delete his comments off WIT and WRAL. So I shared him again. Not the post, but I did share what he shared. Because that's not good. A school shooting in Texas. Oh, God. No, I didn't. And I don't think I even want to hear it.
So anyway, I'm going to get off my teacher rant here soon. And I might have to move on to EOGs, which is sort of education-ish.
I was going to write an article about Meghan Markle's dad not coming to the wedding, but I just can't deal with it. It's too much. And I cannot deal with any more people like just saying dumb things on the internet. Don't send them to me. Because last night, I was like totally undone. I was like, how can there be this many idiots in the world? It's truly a worry. People that like you think might be normal, they're not. I mean, I just don't understand it. Anyway, coming from someone who's totally sane. Anyway, I don't know if I am or not. Well, Amon says poop pants, so I'm going to go deal with that after I finish my
frosted biscuit. And then I'm going to exercise. Tired mom of four boys. I feel like you make excuses for your behavior. Oh, who are you, Jennifer Barton? You're about to get in big trouble.
But I haven't laughed since you started. I watch the regular news and don't need anyone repeating it. Can't deal with you today.
Well, Jennifer, no one's making you be here.
You don't have to be here. I don't mind you. That's so sad for me. What are the excuses for my behavior? That Amos was home for a week and I couldn't go to the gym? That's pretty true. I guess I could have done a workout video, but I'm lazy and I'm admitting it. And I'm also trying to like work and write and resell to agents. And I work probably 16 hours a day and I just can't do everything great, you know? I think we all want to do something great. Like, I need my hair colored. I need a manicure. I need to take my kids like to go to the orthodontist. There's always something that I have to do. I'm not making excuses, but I think it's okay to acknowledge like, holy shit, I suck. I'm not perfect and I never will be. So Jennifer, you don't have to listen to me. You can listen to the news and you can be perfect, but I am not perfect. And I don't want you to go away. I don't think anybody has anything against you, but there's way more in the world that says, get your shit together. And I want to be the place that says, hey, you know what? You're great as you are. You are the best version of yourself today. And you're not perfect, but you're great. And I really sincerely mean that for any woman or man for that matter, or child or teacher or whoever that's watching. You're a good version of yourself and you can always do better. But don't like beat yourself up. Anyway, because I'm not going to. I'm going to go cuddle with Amos and change some pants. And then he and I are going to put away a little laundry. And then we're going to, tonight, watch Little Princess with my kids. And that's going to be fun. And that's about it. Remember, you're always welcome with me. Love y'all.